So it's made up of three different parts. I like to call them the MobX trifecta. You've got MobX itself. MobX it was created by Michel Westray. He works for Facebook now. And it is kind of a reactive pattern. I'm not going to talk too much about it, but it's essentially the engine underneath this. And you don't generally have to think too much about it. It'll just do its job. You also have MobX React Lite. There's MobX React and MobX React Lite. We use MobX React Lite because we don't need support for class components. We don't use class components, so we're just using function components, and you can use the light version of it if that's all you're doing. And you'll see that in action as well as I move into this. And MobX-State-Tree itself, which allows you to create the data models, it does things like data validation at runtime, as well as inferred TypeScript types that you can just pull out of your runtime types. You'll see the runtime types here, but everything that you do for runtime types, meaning things that actually run in your JavaScript, will be inferred into your build, compile time TypeScript as well. So there's some really cool stuff, and you can build stores of data that are centralized so that you can pull them out, and then you can subscribe to them using MobX React Lite and make sure that things get updated whenever, like components re-render at the right time.
Okay. That makes sense.
Cool.